Don't Tell Sophia took the grade one Judmont Spinster last time out. We're gonna look at Don't Tell Sophia working at Keeneland on Friday, going a half mile with Joe Rocco Jr. up.
Yeah, she works on her own here, and she's had a tremendous year, bar from one effort at Oaklawn Park in the Azari, Donna, and you can speak more to that.
Yeah, this is a filly who's won four of her five last races. In the one race where she got beat, and that was behind closed hatches, she was only beaten a length and three quarters, was the only race in the last five starts that she was wearing a bar shoe that was over a wet, fast track. So this here looked like a nice maintenance move. I don't think they were looking for her to go fast. I liked everything I saw about this work, Tom.
You know, the rider shakes her up a little bit right there, Donna, down the stretch, and then he grabs her again, and she responds. Don't Tell Sophia finishes up well in this work. The beginning of the work, kind of easy. That's her style. She comes from behind. But I think she's coming to the wire full of horse here. I like what I see. The hands are very still. Ears are waiting for a command. Don't Tell Sophia, Spinster champion. This race, she'd be very competitive.
The only time the rider asked her, I think, was to get the lead change at the top of the stretch. And when she did, she quickened up.
Yeah, she kicked.
Yeah, she kicked on. 11 for 22 lifetime letter grades. Donna.
A.
B here.
B plus for me. 48 flat for the four furlongs.
Remarkable purchase price at a Keeneland sale and on the precipice of a big moment in the Breeders' Cup Distaff. Don't Tell Sophia working on Friday at Keeneland.